Hello students, today's topic we are going to discuss from unit 2. The title of unit 2 is partial differential equations. Under that we are going to see the topic, which is solving homogeneous linear partial differential equations. As discussed earlier, we already have three types of functions. The first one was exponential, second was trigonometry, and the third is algebraic functions. In today's class, we are going to just observe how these trigonometric solutions are handled. So let's get into the problem. Solve d square minus 2 d d dash plus 2 d dash the whole square of z is equal to sine x minus y. So first we need to observe how to find the solution of this particular PDE. Why do I call this as a PDE? So wherever the existence of d and d dash comes in, we will call it as a PDE. So how does this d stands for a partial derivative equation? So this capital D denotes, as already told you, it is just denoting, it's a differential, partial differential operator, which is denoting dou by dou x, right? And d dash will be represented by dou by dou y. So there, hence it's called as a partial differential equation. So how to find the solution for this particular partial differential equation? It consists of two parts. The first part will be the complementary function and the second part is the particular integral. The complementary function comes from the left hand side and the particular integral comes from the right hand side. So after finding both separately, we're going to combine and give the answer. So solution: to find the complementary function, as I told you, we are moving on to the first part, that is the left hand side. So the basic procedure here is we replace this capital D by m and d dash by 1. So in this particular equation, if you are going to replace capital D, wherever C, you just observe where the capital D's are. So capital D is, replace it by m. So d square, it becomes m square. And 2 d d dash, so d will be replaced by m and d dash will be replaced by 1 plus 2 into 1. So now you know that this looks like a quadratic equation. So the power is 2. So we are going to factorize it. So we are going to find the roots. So ordinary factorization is impossible for this particular equation. So we will be using minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So by doing that formula, we get this root and we get the two roots here. So you know that complex roots appear always in pairs. So this is the first and second roots. So this compared with this one, alpha plus or minus I beta, comparing the real part in place of this, it will be carrying the value 1, and beta, it carries the value 1. So whenever complex root comes, what will be the complementary function? The complementary function will be e power alpha x a cos beta x plus b sine beta x. This is the general format. So since alpha is 1, beta is 1, I will be writing e power x into a cos x plus b sine x. So this will be my complementary function. So depending upon your alpha value and beta value, this will keep on changing, right? So this is the first part of the problem, that is the complementary function. As I told you, we have completed. So suppose if you are able to factorize it in a normal way, usually, then as known to be, accordingly, you have to check whether the roots are repeated or non-repeated, and accordingly you have to frame the complementary function. Right, now let's move on to the second part of the problem, which I told you, that is the particular integral. So particular integral, when I observe, it is a trigonometric function. So let's see how I'm going to do it. Right, so now particular integral is equal to 1 divided by the denominator, that what is the problem, what is given here, that I will be writing it in the denominator, into sine of x minus y. So rule for the trigonometric functions. So whenever trigonometric functions appear as your particular integral, you are going to replace d square by a square with a minus sign, and d dash square as replaced by b square with a negative sign, and d dash is replaced by minus of ab. So what is the value of a and b here? Where do you find them? So A is the coefficient of x and B is the coefficient of y. So A is the coefficient of x and B is the coefficient of y. So what is the coefficient of x here? It's 1. And what is the coefficient of y here? Minus 1. So accordingly you have to put them. So A square, if you are going to square it, it's going to be 1, and just drop the negative sign there. And B square is minus 1, when you square it, it becomes positive 1, and you have to use the negative sign here as per the rule. And DD dash is minus of AB, so A is 1, B is minus 1, you will be getting minus of 1 into minus 1, which will give you plus 1. So DD dash will carry the value plus 1. So what do you do automatically? After getting these values from the trigonometric function, you go back and substitute it here. So in this place D square, I'm replacing it by minus 1. And you have minus 2. So minus 2 into DD dash. DD dash carries the value 1. So substitute it there. Plus 2. Plus 2 into D dash square. D dash square carries the value minus 1. So substitute there. So what do you get? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 2. Clear? So always you have to keep a check that your denominator is not becoming 0. In this problem, our denominator is not becoming 0. So we need not to worry about it. But suppose if the denominator is becoming 0, you have to multiply an x to the numerator and differentiate the denominator with respect to D months. And now when simplifying, I'm getting minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, I'm getting minus 5. So sine of x minus 5. So the general solution is given by, as mentioned earlier, y is equal to the complementary function plus the particular integral. So what was the complementary function? As we have done it right now, e power x, a into cos x plus b sin x. So that was your complementary function. So complementary function should be written first, e power x into a cos x plus b sin x minus 1 upon 5, that is your particular integral what you have just arrived, 1 by 5 sine of x minus 1. So this is the general solution for the given PDE. This was the problem. So what we have done, we have broken. I am just giving a revision again, a recap. So first we tried to solve this problem by finding the complementary function, and then after completing complementary function, then we move on to the particular integral. So complementary function is replacing all the d by m and d dash by 1 and solving it, we get the roots. You may get real roots as well as complex roots. Depending upon the roots, you have to decide the complementary function. And after finding the complementary function, we go with the trigonometric we go with the particular integral. In particular integral, we may observe whether you may have exponential or trigonometric. Based on that particular thing, we will be applying the different types of rules here. For trigonometric functions, we are having d square, d dash square and dd dash. So finding a is the coefficient of x and b is the coefficient of y. So then finding out the values, replacing it in place of a and b, you get the values of d square, d dash square and d dd dash. Then go back and substitute in the denominator. Substitution, solve it, that is simplify it, and you get an answer. And the final solution should be given as y is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So finally adding both, you get the solution of this particular problem. Thank you, students.